And we are live. Hello, everyone. Welcome back. We're going to get started with one of those bad boys right there. How is everyone doing?
We are live. Hello, everyone. Welcome back.
Levels work, apparently. There's my playback. It works. Technology works. Now let me reorder my screens because I had to shut that down. I don't know why YouTube, if they know you're going live, why do they play back your own stream? Thank you. Thank you, everyone. So let's do a quick round of hellos. Then we'll catch up. And then I have some boxes. So we're going to unbox some stuff. Gary Davlin, I don't know how you do it, dude, but number one in the chat this evening. One of those right there. Rob Baker and Jake. Tarman 45. Hello. Let's see who else we have here. Mr. Dusty Wilson. Rob Baker and Jay. Dusty Wilson. Did I say that already? Autism Rocks, Acceptance, Awareness Through Music. Hello, Jazz Hands. AQ Music in the house, dude, what's up? And Sasso, Grandpa Joe. See, this is the problem when I scroll back in the comments, but I'm doing it just to say hello to everyone. Otherwise, there's these awkward delays. Uneffing Believable, dude, what's up? Joe Crow, Blind Eye, Grandpa Joe, Tim Thomas, and company. I'm scrolling. Getting down to the end now. So Brian from Oregon and company, hello. So today is, actually it's official. Today is July 3rd. Tomorrow is, oh wow, tomorrow's the 4th. No, today's the 3rd. Sunday is the 4th. So 4th of July weekend, for those that don't know, or for those that aren't in the U.S., we are a global community. So for those that aren't in the U.S., it's a holiday weekend here in the U.S. It's July 4th. Where we go in the pool, eat hot dogs and hamburgers on the grill, and just kind of enjoy the great outdoors and fireworks, of course, right? Fireworks. There was a live show last week, and I wound up taking that show offline since some people are asking, what happened to the show last week? I typically don't do that. There was a few reasons why I did, but that's another conversation another day. And for certain peeps in the house, Gary, AQ, Grandpa Joe and company, Brian from Oregon, maybe tomorrow night, if you guys want to do the old school Patreon style hang. There was an email floating around. I think I started it. It had all of our emails on there. So if someone could surface that up to the top of my inbox, I'll be grateful. And figure like 10:30, 11 o'clock tomorrow night, if you guys want to do a 4th of July hangout, I would very much welcome that. And Ian says, have to work on July 4th, but holiday pay is cool. Holiday pay is always cool. Absolutely. And I got some congrats on the bike. I appreciate that. So for those that don't follow me on Instagram or Facebook, you should, because that's my behind the scenes stuff that's going on in my life. That's where I usually post life stuff. I bought a new old motorcycle. I bought a 2003 Road King Classic. It had me at hello. It's it just you know, you have to remember for the motorcycle people in the house, probably know this already, but if you're not a motorcycle person, the reason why I like an older bike, it's a few reasons. Number one, they're cheaper than a new bike. If anyone's ever priced out a new Harley, it's crazy expensive, at least in my book of rules. So you get something that is, you know, about 75% off of what it was. It's actually all black and all chrome. Just like guitars, by the way, just like guitars, when you upgrade your guitar, all those upgrades don't add up to much on resale value. So the person buying your upgraded guitar, they get all those upgrades for free because the guitar is only worth what the guitar is worth. In fact, it's sometimes harder to sell a guitar that's been upgraded because you have to get someone that wants those things that you put on it. Okay. In this particular case, on this particular bike, it had everything I wanted. So I got the benefit of a low price on someone else's customization, which was right up my alley. So it was just one of those, yeah, why not, right? My second year in a row, there's no vacation with COVID, because of COVID. So, you know, it gives me an excuse to get out a little bit. for not a lot of dough. Now if they would just deliver the bike, it's funny because this was Harley Davidson of Ocean County, New Jersey, went in last weekend, Saturday, saw it, fell in love with it, went back. It was either Monday or Tuesday. They were very busy. So they said, come back Thursday. You could pick up the bike. I'm like, okay. Went there Thursday. They're like, oh no, you need to pay for it first. I'm like, yeah, I would have paid for it on Monday or Tuesday, but you told me to come back Thursday because you were busy. So then I paid for the bike. And then they said, oh, well, hopefully we'll have it ready by next week. So I'm like, how did we go from pick it up Thursday to now? I'm like, these are the little things that frustrate me in life. By the way, a proper cheers to everyone. But I will be patient. I'll take a deep breath. Good things come to those who wait, even though I'm impatient by nature. How do I like the ape hangers? I love ape hangers, actually. There's ape hangers on my Sportster. Also, if you follow me on Facebook or Instagram, you would know that. And the ape hangers, it was interesting. I originally bought them for cosmetic reasons. So going back to 1995, I bought my first motorcycle from some dude that worked at a gas station, and it just looked so cool. And I knew nothing about, I didn't even know how to ride a motorcycle, and I bought that motorcycle. It was very cheap. Didn't even run. I was probably dumb for buying it, to be honest with you, because I wound up putting some money into it to get it up and running. But I liked the way it looked, and not knowing anything better, I couldn't afford a new one. So I bought this cheap used one, and I still have that cheap used one. That's my 89 Sportster. And it runs like a dream because I made it run like a dream. You know, you could throw money at anything and make it run like a dream, if you know what I mean. So, and when I was at the shop, Lombardi's in Staten Island, some guy had some badass bike with ape hangers. And I told the parts guy, I'm like, can we put that on my bike? He goes, yeah, you could do anything you want. And I did, not knowing if I'd like it or not. I just liked the way it looked. And I actually happen to like it. I'm very used to that. So, and these are real tall ones. So I'm really excited. I did take it for a test drive. And man, it's just, it was big upgrade from what I have. I'll say that much. Brian says Road King is a great bike. Congratulations. What's a difference you feel when you ride? The biggest difference is, it's funny. I used to joke with people that don't know anything about motorcycles. And I used to say riding a Sportster, especially an old Sportster, it's like riding a lawnmower. A little bumpy, right? It's a little, you know, you feel everything. This one felt really smooth. And, you know, my Sportster is an 883 and this one is a 1450. I think I hit 60 in second gear and I wasn't trying to be like, you know, Evel Knievel or anything. It just happened to see a lot of power in that engine. And man, it was like the Sportster. To get to 60, you feel uncomfortable. That's like a nice 40 mile an hour ride on the Sportster. I hit 60 in second gear on this thing, and it was really smooth, really comfortable. So, you know, 30 years later, buying myself something bigger than what I bought in 1995, man, what a pleasant upgrade, you know. And I think you could really get a good deal on a used motorcycle. Listen, for me, money doesn't grow on trees, despite what it looks like in the background. Some of these heads I've had since like the late 80s, just to be clear. I didn't buy all this stuff yesterday. I'm very frugal with money. And I really do like a used guitar. I buy a lot of used guitars. Like a used guitar, I think a used motorcycle, you just get a tremendous amount of value for not a lot of dough. You know, so anyway, that's all I'll say about motorcycles because I don't want to, you know, it's a guitar channel. So let's talk about guitars. But since you asked, there was a thorough answer for you. Mr. Tudor said, had a 95 Sports, the 1200, great bike. Wait, what did he say here? Sold it after I saw a guy die in a cycle at an intersection, decided like four steel walls around me on the road, too many idiots on their phones. Yeah, yeah. Well, my answer to that, and maybe this is good to say just for anyone that either rides a motorcycle or might think about riding a motorcycle. I am very aware that it is crazy out there, right? We used to be afraid of drunk drivers. Now we're afraid of people not looking Think about that. When you were drunk, at least you were trying to look. People are now like this in their phones. They're not looking, which is scary. So for me, because I don't use it as a mode of transportation, it's really just a joyride. I take that into account. I stay away from other cars. I am looking left, right at every intersection. I don't go fast. I'm not into, even though it's a bigger bike, a bigger engine, my goal is just to enjoy the fresh air, not to be doing 80 down a highway or bar hop and all that. I'm very, very conservative. And I encourage everyone to be conservative because it is scary. It's scary when you hear about the kind of accidents that occur. Mad Raj, dude. Mad Raj, send me an email tomorrow night, 10:30, 11 o'clock. We'll do an old school Patreon hang. So let me see what else here. Mad Raj, still alive and rocking. Tactical said, yeah, I had my accidents in the 80s, kept the respect for it, and I accept the risk. Yeah. Gary says, I live out of town and people bring their high-speed bikes out here to run them at full speed because there aren't any cops. I'm surprised more people don't get killed. Yeah, you know, it's, listen, I don't want to jinx myself. I'm going to start knocking on wood that I've always been very fortunate. But I honestly believe that safety starts with you, right? Is being very aware of your surroundings, very aware of your surroundings. Now more than ever before, you have to be paying attention. You know, cause it's the other driver. You have to be really careful. It's dangerous. Yeah. Ian says, watch out, for deer. Deer is another one. Deer is another one, which, there's a lot of deer in New Jersey, but same type of thing. You know, listen, maybe these are the things I convinced myself, so I could get on a bike and ride it. But you know, if you're not going fast, you're wearing the proper safety equipment, okay? And you're being very aware of your surroundings. Even if you took a spill, you know, or hit something, you know, I think you have a lot more chance of surviving if you're doing 30 than if you're doing 100. If you catch my drift, right? So just be careful. It's, yes, bikes can stop very quickly. Quicker than a car. There's less to stop, right? Chris Torres. Okay, great segue. Chris said, thoughts on sawtooth guitars. Did you get the sigh in there? My thoughts on sawtooth guitars. I wouldn't buy one if that is telling. I feel like sawtooth guitars are very inexpensive, affordable guitars. I think they're like Donner guitars. With the difference is a Donner guitar is $100. So if you want to learn how to refret a guitar, paint a guitar, or give a guitar to a gift to a kid that doesn't know if they want to play a guitar, or just have something to keep in the trunk of your car in any weather condition so you have a guitar with you, Donner is a great $100 guitar to do that sort of thing, right? Sawtooth, you know, they latched on to Michelangelo Badio, who's a very nice guy, by the way. I interviewed him once. I met him several times. One of the most humble, nicest guys that I've met doing this thing. He's with them. And I think they need someone. But even his demos, and he's a phenomenal guitar player. Even his demos, when I heard his demos on Sawtooth, they sounded rough. You know, and he's, like I said, usually they say it's not the wand, it's the magician, right? That's why we all sound like the way we sound. He didn't even sound good on that thing. You know, they always say, you give Eddie Van Halen a sawtooth, he'll sound like Eddie Van Halen. Michelangelo Badio did not sound like himself on that guitar. It sounded rough. And I just think that, I don't know. I would personally pass on it. Yeah, Mad Raj, I know you know him as well. A phenomenal person, like beyond phenomenal guitar player. This is a guitar player that I forget that one song that he wrote. It's very popular, Intermezzo, I think it's called. And it's written on a 24. He wrote it on a 24-fret guitar, and he told me the story. And he said someone handed him a 20, I think it was like a 21 fret, like Fender Strat, right? Like one of the older ones. And he said he had to, they like gave him the guitar and said, hey, go do your thing. And he was like, wait, the song's written on a 24 fret. Do you have that? They said, no. He goes, okay, don't worry about it. I'll just transpose it while I'm playing. If you heard that song, which is sick, right? Everything is just super fast. He transposed his own song, his own scales, his everything with three less frets. Like, in fact, I recorded him playing that song, geez, many years ago at Winter NAMM, and he played it with David Reffitt, and just phenomenal. Both of those guys are phenomenal guitar players. Yeah, so I think that Sawtooth is probably a little bit more because they have a good name. I mean, he's Michelangelo Badio's a very well-respected guitarist. I actually feel bad for Michael because he was with Dean forever. And it's one of those things, I don't know what happened. I've answered this question before. It always seems to be business. Business is usually the answer. But I was sad to, you know, usually I'm not affected when people leave companies. I was kind of sad to see him leave the Dean family because, man, he's been with Dean forever, you know. That one hurt a little bit, you know. And then of all places, it's not like he went to ESP or he went, you know, he went to Sawtooth. So it was like, dude, what happened, you know? Sawtooth or Harley Benton? Truthfully, I'd buy a Harley Benton. You know why? Because they're people just like us. They are very in tune with what we want. Harley Benton is owned by Thomann. Thomann has very deep pockets to do it right. And they also have deep pockets to give you something affordable without worrying about the bottom line, like the margin. Of course, they're making money, but, you know, just look at their Indonesian guitar prices versus what another company's Indonesian guitar is. It's half the price. It's half the price. So you're getting a hard quality, a good quality for half the price. Hard Luck Kings. That was another one. Actually, I wanted a Hard Luck Kings guitar. I was going to buy a Hard Luck Kings guitar. And when I saw the reviews on it, see, even I'm affected by reviews. People said they were awful. And I didn't bother. Now, if they wanted to send one out, I would give it a go. But I wouldn't. I probably wouldn't buy one. You know, listen, we are affected by our, you know, how we influence each other. And I know I'm here influencing you, but believe it or not, you all influence me as much as I influence you. It's a very reciprocal two-way street here. Make no mistake about that. We definitely influence each other. The fact that I'm reading your comments and we're having this conversation, we're influencing each other. I've never heard good things about Hard Luck Kings. Now, if someone sent me one and I said, wow, this actually plays great. And it's a great price. And wow, it looks great. I would tell you. But from what I've seen and what I've heard, that hasn't occurred. So Alan's Guitar Channel says we are all under the influence here. We absolutely are. DR Guitars, dude. DR, in case you missed the memo, tomorrow night, 10:30, 11 o'clock, a little reunion. If you're around, hopefully you're on an email thread. I asked someone to recirculate that email thread. So we'll do a little 4th of July special. Mr. Tudor says the new Sir Discovery vid by Pete Thorne yesterday is ridiculously good. Yeah. Well, Pete is not only a talented player, Pete can make anything sound good. Sir is a great brand and Pete's a great player with great production quality. Nothing shitty is going to come out of Pete. In fact, I've heard people say that they actually want to hear other reviews. Like, how does it really sound? Because Pete's stuff always sounds amazing. But sometimes when you go home and plug it in, it's a little different. You're not Pete Thorne. You don't produce like Pete Thorne. You don't master your videos and your audio like Pete Thorne. So how does it really sound? That's like the concern on the other side of the house, right? How does something really sound? But anyway, I'm sure it's a great guitar, you know. Truth. So let me just eyeball these comments real quick. Pizza sounds good. I love pizza. I love pizza from Staten Island. Grandpa Joe knows that. Quentin James, dude, I don't know if I said hello to you. Grumpy Mike, hello. Great Vanzini. DR. Yeah, Ian said great value for the buck in Harley Benton. Yeah, I would say if you wanted a really good guitar for not a lot of money, you can't go wrong with Harley Benton, but they could be anywhere between $300 and $500. And if you want a $100 guitar, I'd look at like a Donner on Amazon. And the nice thing I like about buying on Amazon, it's like a no questions asked return policy. If you don't like it or if something's wrong with it, by the way, I return very little stuff that I buy, but the few times I've returned stuff to Amazon, it's like bone dead simple. You don't have to get someone on the other end of the line convincing you to keep it, right? And I've been down that road too. I will not name the store because I don't want to incriminate anyone, but I bought an interface that was recommended to me. This is many years ago. It was crackling. It was like incompatible with my software. And I'm in, you know, IT for a living. There was just the driver was not driving properly. Anyway, I wanted to return it. And it was like, oh, well, try doing this and try defragmenting your disk. I'm like, dude, stop. I don't want it. You know, it was trying to turn you into keeping something. Amazon, I like Amazon because it's no questions asked. If you're not totally satisfied, you could return it. And you know what I love about that is it gives you more confidence, it gives you more confidence to buy something and read the reviews. I think I probably agree with 95% of what I read. And you know, what's funny when I read a review, I always read the one stars, not the five stars. Because I don't need to read the five stars. I want to read the one stars. And when somebody says, when there's like 3 1-star reviews and someone says, well, the blue was brighter in the picture. It's like, okay, I don't care about that. Someone else might say, it doesn't fit right on my lap. It's a 1-star. It's like, yeah, I don't care about that either. But if somebody said it showed up and the neck was cracked, if it showed up and the frets were... had massive frets. Like I trust reviews based on me gauging a 1-star, you know, and I'll tell you, if you take the time and read the 1-star, usually it's spot on. Cause you could determine, okay, do I care about what someone else is complaining about? Or do I not care about what they're complaining about? You know, DR says Amazon's really good about returning stuff. Yeah. So that's Harley Benton. You know, the problem with Harley Benton is you have to get it from Germany. And I've heard that it's not such a great return policy. And I hate to say that. I'm friendly with the guys at Thomann, but a few of my peeps bought stuff from Thomann and, you know, random issues, not a lot, just like one or two people had one or two issues. And it was, you know, when you're in the US and you're dealing with a $200 item from Germany, it gets a little tricky, right? So, but again, very small percentage. The Harley Bentons I've played, I haven't had any problems with them. I would recommend them. But again, you're in a $300 to $500 price range. So I would say if you want a cheap guitar, Harley Benton's great, or Donner on Amazon is good. You know, from China to German to customer. No, actually, most of the Harley Bentons are Indonesian. Indonesia. Yep. Z Sounds is great. Z Sounds is also American Musical Supply, and I do like them. I bought some stuff from them in the past. And I did have a problem with one of my, when I bought my Strat and Tele. I think I told everyone I had a little problem with the nut. Man, they took care of it. Brian from Oregon, dude, you are too kind. Dude, thank you. Wow. You are too kind. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And I will take you up on your offer if I am ever in your neck of the woods. Once I start traveling again with work, which I haven't done yet, I would love to ride a motorcycle with you on some back roads and all that. I'd welcome that. And I appreciate that text earlier today. So, dude, you're too kind. Thank you so much. And I hope I see you tomorrow night as well. London Bailey, dude. I actually saw you. I don't know what happened, Landon. I was flipping through like my feed in YouTube. It wasn't like videos, and you popped up and you were playing something from like 95, like a live show. It was really cool video. I was watching that earlier. I was laying on my bed watching you play the guitar in front of a live audience on a pretty legit sized stage too. Grumpy Mike, dude, thank you so much for the tone jar. Says, why not? Happy Independence Day to you as well. And thank you for the thanks to my family, and the same to you, brother. I hope you have a great 4th, and best to you and your family as well. Dude, you're always a gentleman. You always throw something in the tip jar, and I am very grateful for that, so thank you. Desert Doug says, what is your cheapest guitar? Whew. I think DR Guitars has my cheapest guitar. the Glary was probably the cheapest guitar I've ever owned. After that are the Donner guitars for sure. After that, I had some Harley Bentons. I think I sold them all. Not because I didn't like them, by the way. It's just like I've always said, you can't keep everything. And, you know, usually you thin out the stuff that, like if you have a copy of something and the real thing, you thin out the copies, right? In fact, Mad Raj has one of my Harley Bentons. In fact, I wish I kept that one. That was actually a really nice one that Mad Raj has. I think it was a 7. I don't think it was an 8-string. It was 7-string, a purple burst. It was just gorgeous guitar, fan fret. My most expensive guitar? Well, I have a few. And when I say expensive, just to be clear, it's not what I paid for it. It's probably the street value of what it's worth. The John Mayer Nebula is still selling for $5,000, which is insane. I have one of those. And again, I didn't pay anywhere. I didn't even pay. I paid less than half of that, just to be clear. But those go for about $5,000. My Rico Juniors all day long. Those are $3,000-$4,000 guitars. My Les Pauls. Every Les Paul I own is up there. My USA. You know what? My Sir is a very expensive guitar. My Nags is a very expensive guitar. But like my motorcycle story, if you tune in regularly, you know I've done a lot of content on how never to pay full price for anything. You don't have to pay full price. But those, I would say those are up there in terms of my expensive guitars. Of my expensive guitars, the ones I like the best, truthfully, I love my Rico Jr. guitars. I just look at them and I go, wow, those look so good. What's odd is they're not very comfortable to play. I mean, they're like, they really are battle axes, like the Vixens and the Diva, which I showed on my channel a month ago now. I just love those guitars, and they're rare, man. You just can't get them cheap, and they're just phenomenal guitars. I always loved the Vixen, and I finally got my Diva, and I'll tell you what, it's the best looking Diva I've ever seen is the one I own, and the natural with the gold. It's just I love that guitar. RJ Orthman, dude, thank you so much for the super chat. It says hello from Vancouver, Washington. Always good stuff. Dude, thank you so much. One of those right there for you. Chris Southen says, I agree. Rico are the best. Yes, the Vixen is comfortable. I have 4. You know why the Vixen isn't that comfortable for me? Because of that, the V goes up like this, right? So this is the outside. The inside doesn't just go like that. It goes like that. And there's like that, like angles. And as everyone knows, I sit with my guitar in my lap, and man, that just digs in. But I wouldn't sell it for that. There's like a perfect example of a guitar that is not the most comfortable for me to play, but I wouldn't sell it. I love that guitar. Just love the way it looks. In fact, Jackson tried ripping off that copy. I forget. Someone tell me the artist that made the Jackson. It was a Jackson artist guitar, and it was the V with those little wings inside the V. And it just did not look like the Rico Jr. Mad Raj says, dude, I love my Virgin. I really do. You know, that's got the chameleon color. It's got the Rockfield Black Betty's, and it's a cheap guitar, dude. That's made in China. It is, but it looks great. It's got the proper big diamond inlays, the widow headstock, the chameleon. That was probably on my list of super scores. I think I paid like $250 for that guitar. That guitar looks like a $1,000 guitar. Who was it? Corey from Trivium. Is that who it was? Okay. Dane says I had Dane, I think we met. I think we met when I was with Philip in his area many years ago. I think we came by your place. Had a great day. Philip hung out in my shop all day. I think I was there. I think we may have met. Nice to have you. The guy from Trivium. Yeah. But yeah, listen, at the end of the day, I love my Fenders. I love my Gibsons like everyone else, right? But when I get into the exotic stuff, my Nags is stunning. The Sur is nice. Truthfully, it's not as stunning as my Nags. If I had to choose a Sur or Nags, I'd take a Nags. The PRS Nebula, it's that finish. I wanted that guitar as soon as I saw it. And luckily I know a guy and, he got me one. Just a crazy good deal. Crazy good deal. Maybe it was Phil Demmel. I don't remember. 116, 17th the week before. Oh, at NAMM. Okay, so we met at NAMM. Can you remind me? By the way, if you ask me a question I don't answer, just ask again. I rarely scroll back up. Just ask me again. Desert Doug says, can you remind me what you paid for your BFG? Seems like they've gone way up. I think it was, Grandpa Joe will know exactly what I paid. I want to say $650, $625, something like that. If Grandpa Joe remembers, because he paid less than I did. And we bought it from the same place. I just don't remember. I want to say six something, but yeah, I think they doubled in price. I think they doubled in price. $650. Yep. Okay. DR. Right. DR has one too. We all bought them at the same time. A whole bunch of us, bought them at the same time. That was probably the best deal I ever got on a USA made Gibson ever. And Grandpa Joe, what did you pay for that? Was it like $625? I think you got it even better. Better than, yeah, $650 all day long. Oh, DR had one. We'll have to dig into that one a little. And by the way, DR, I owe you an apology, dude. It's the weeks have been tough. I do want to catch up. And again, if you're around tomorrow night, let me know. Wow, you sold it. Hopefully you made a little bit of money. Okay, $635. Yeah, that's... that was the best deal. I bought that on the spot. I knew. So, and I've done that a few times. You see something and it's like, wait a second. This should not be $650. I bought it then. In fact, I think I told everyone the story. I'll tell everyone a quick funny story. I was going to Red Lobster with my wife that night. And I said, hey, do you mind if we stop at Guitar Center? She said, yeah. So we stopped at Guitar Center. I saw the guitar. They only had one with the P90s. I wanted it with the P90s. And I said, I have to get it. She was like, okay. So I bought that guitar for $650. As we're pulling out of Guitar Center, I said, maybe we should skip dinner tonight because, you know, I just dropped $650 on a guitar. I got the look. But I was just kidding. but it was fun. It was fun to, you know, earn the look. You know what I mean? Honey, I can't take you out to dinner because I just bought a guitar, you know. Janice Lala, hello. So, the biscuits are good. I'll tell you, I like Red Lobster. I've had a few bad experiences because I like lobster, obviously, and sometimes it doesn't taste all that fresh. I think in the 20 years I've been going there, maybe two or three times I had to send something back, just wasn't right. But it's pretty good. It's pretty good win ratio when you think about it, especially seafood. Seafood could be tricky, you know. But yeah, I enjoy Red Lobster. What is your favorite Kiesel to play? You know, I've been meaning to do a video on. By the way, everyone probably has noticed my video. I've been down in doing a lot of videos. It's just. I'm trying really hard to just get back in the swing of things. You know, last year was really tough for me. Not that I got COVID, thank God. My family was all healthy, but It was an overwhelming year for those that were working. And by the way, I'd love to poll you all. I feel like I worked harder last year than I worked in the past 20 years, right? Work was harder. I work from home, but before COVID, I used to travel a lot. When you travel, there's a lot of downtime, which gives you sanity. So I was working the moment I woke up to the moment I went to bed, nonstop. Kids were home doing at-home school. And it was like Groundhog's Day. It was Groundhog's Day. And we didn't go on vacation. There was nothing to break up the year. And I'm still kind of in that mode, right? They are just within the past 2 months opening. I only got vaccinated like 2 months ago. So, you know, I got in a rut, and not a bad rut, not like a rut like I lay in bed and I don't want to do anything. I got in a rut like I'm just, at the end of the day, I'm tired, you know. Okay, Kiesel came out with a new model, $3,600. You know, I got to be honest with you. I'm surprised Kiesel doesn't charge more for their instruments. They are probably the best deal for a USA-made guitar, a custom USA-made guitar. Desert Doug said he was working nonstop. Yeah, I think a lot of us are. Those that were working, I feel like were working a lot. You know, I think the COVID thing affected everyone a little bit differently. But yeah, it definitely affected me where it, you know, just made things harder to, you know, cut into the free time. My opinion of the original DBZ guitars, not the Diamond guitars. Great question. I think in the long run, the original DBZ guitars will be worth something. I still have a few of them. I sold a few, and I sold them with half a heart. They're beautiful guitars. But again, I don't need like 10 DBZ guitars, right? So I think I have two or three of them. But like I had an Imperial. I shouldn't have sold that. That was just a stunning guitar. It was like an indigo blue with a black burst, real thin body, ES-335 looking. But again, I got good money for it. And it was a guitar I didn't play. But I think they have good resale value. You have to remember, Dean Zielinski, when he was at DBZ Guitars, was a very short period of time. Now, the Diamond guitars are also nice. But from a collectability perspective, I think the original DBZs will be worth more than the Diamond. But the Diamonds were also nice guitars, you know. I have both. I have a few DBZs. I have a DBZ Cavallo. My Cavallo is Carina, in that like honey-colored Carina. It's a gorgeous guitar. In fact, I got it from R&A Music. You know, it's got, it's Carina, like honey-colored Carina with tinted Carina with all gold pickups, USA Seymour Duncans. It's stunning. Now, it doesn't, sadly, it doesn't, it's not the original DBZ with the metal medallion on the headstock. Working this much, playing guitar has really helped me. 35 minutes in, what's in the boxes? Good segue. RJ says, my honest opinion, best bang for the buck for U.S. guitars was the Vandenberg guitars. I had a Vandenberg. A buddy of mine sold me his Vandenberg. I don't have it anymore. I wound up selling it. Someone just made me an offer I couldn't refuse. So it went. But yeah, I agree. Vandenbergs were great guitars. Gary says, my organization is down to 3 people with 1 person working half-time in Wisconsin. We had 12 to 14. Almost don't need an office anymore. It's interesting times. Adam D, hello. I would love, Chris, I'd love to try an Edwards. That's like on my list of guitars. I'd love to get an Edwards. I just, you know, it's only available in Japan and they have to import them. But I'd love one. Okay, so I mentioned last week, for those that tuned in, that I am Sweetwater is really good people, not just a good company with, you know, good service and all that, but good people, okay? I've yet to have a bad experience with people. And just to be clear, you could say that, well, yeah, because you work together. No, I've worked with people that I didn't have good experiences with. We've all done that from day one. In fact, Sweetwater advertises on my website for over 10 years. Okay. So when you think about that, they've actually trusted me more than I've trusted them. Right. And I that might not be totally true, but I'm just trying to be illustrative here that they've put a lot of faith into what I do, my integrity, the website, the content that I put out there. And over 10 years, they've been my customer. When you think about it, again, trying to paint a picture here, they've been my customer for over 10 years. So this year, a very, very nice guy over there told me, he actually acknowledged that. He said, of all the influencers we've worked with, we've actually been working with you the longest, and we're thankful for that. You've always been a man of your word. You have integrity. Just really just said everything that made me blush, right? And he said, we want to do more this year. And you know, what do you have in mind? So it was really an open discussion to do stuff together. So the last outdoor video was a sponsored video. It was like a sponsored slash collab video where I had some stuff, they sent some stuff, and we just did a really nice video on those Supro amps. So I was talking to my buddy over there again, and he said, what do you have in mind this time? And I said, one of the things I've been doing was playing a lot of acoustic guitar lately. So I said, what I'd love to do is another outdoor video and maybe get a few acoustic guitars and see if the size, like how they project, right? Because I have some distance. And he was like, let's do it. So what do you need? I said, well, I have some of the guitars. There's one that I don't have. So he's sending me one guitar, which I didn't get yet. And I said, I'll do an acoustic thing, but we should also plug in. So he sent one guitar, one acoustic amp. I have the acoustic amp. And to make the make it scientific, each guitar should be like strung up the same. So he sent over some care and maintenance products. So I'm going to do three videos. I'm going to do a setup of all the guitars I'm going to do in that video, so you could see what I would actually do behind the scenes to prepare these guitars for that video. That'll be a setup video. I'm going to do a video of the guitar they're sending, a video of the amp they're sending, and then the outdoor video. So like four videos, all put together with the help of Sweetwater. And I love that kind of collaboration because it's fun. Think about this. Some companies, this is true, they just tell you what they want. Sweetwater said, what do I want to do? And then they help me do it. That's how they're sponsoring. Like, what do you need, right, to pull this off? So really just like, perfect scenario. I'm super thankful for that. And this is what, now I have everything except for another guitar that they're sending. I'm not going to tell you the guitar. It should be a surprise. Before we unbox, let me just check the comments real quick. Janice, I don't know if I said hello to you. If not, hello. Ian said, depending on the weather, absolutely, especially with acoustic guitars. I need a cool day. In fact, I told my buddy at Sweetwater, I said, dude, I'll do the guitar review down here, the amp review down here, the setup down here. But the outdoor, just be patient because this weather right now, if it's too humid or too hot, you know. So maybe that like last grand finale video, maybe it's even a fall video. I don't know. And he's cool with that too. It's, again, sometimes you work with companies and they're like, I need it next, or as soon as like they track it and they're like, you got the piece of gear. When is the video going live? It's like, dude, like, like, whoa. Al John, dude, what's up, man? Jesse Paris says, how many guitars do you own? I own 7 or 8 guitars. Yeah, it's 8 guitars. I need to thin that down a little bit, but 8. All right, let's do this. So I have 3 boxes here. Let's start with the smallest box. Josh says the heat has been throwing my guitar setups out of whack. I got to tell you, this here, I am under the ground, and this is like perfect for a guitar because it's never too hot, never too cold. I do have a dehumidifier just because I'm underground, and it's always the perfect temperature. In fact, look at this. 70 degrees, 44% humidity all year long. The high was 48% humidity. The low is 43% humidity, and it ranges between 68 and 70 degrees. It's perfect. So the guitars that aren't down here with me, the other two that I own upstairs, they're in their cases. If I don't play a guitar, it's in its case. Like, you know. Sorry, I'm just reading comments. Okay, let's start with the small box. So, we are 45 minutes in, perfect timing. So we have, in this one, now this here is the Nita Strauss kit. Now, what's interesting here is I have some of this stuff, okay? But I don't have everything in here, okay? So what's nice about this, by the way, this is a Sweetwater exclusive, okay? You have string cleaner, which, by the way, I love string cleaner. Every time I play an instrument, the thing I do is wipe down the strings. Because if you think about it, the oil in your hands is what degrades a string. I always use string cleaner to wipe down my strings. A multi-tool, fingerboard conditioner, a string clipper, polishing cloths, a little flashlight, string gauge height, a battery, a microfiber cloth, and a tuner. Okay. So, Nita Strauss Hurricane Kit. I'm going to be using this to set those guitars up. Of course, we have some candy. In fact, I'm going to indulge with you all. Does anyone want to take a guess what my favorite candy is in the Sweetwater candy bag? I'm sure I've said this in the past. Do they still give out the Sweetwater van with your purchase? No. Bit of honey. Bit of honey. Al John got it. Alan got it. Yeah, no, it's the bit of honey. It's my favorite. I love honey. I'm the guy that eats honey from a jar with a teaspoon. And it's got to be like organic honey. It can't be non-organic. Even though I don't think there's any honey in here. This is all like high fructose corn syrup, but it still tastes good. Okay, so that is box number one. Sweetwater thanks me. Box number two. Sweetwater thanks me. So, now, remember, we're doing a science project, okay? So, of course, I have guitar cables, but I don't have the same, you know. So, if I'm using three or four acoustic guitars, when I was talking to my buddy, I said, let's get three or four of the same exact cable. Okay, that type of thing. So we did it up again. Good guy over there. Let's start here. So we have let me put this aside for a second. So we have for guitar number one, we have the D'Addario braided cable in blue, in silver, and in red. So three acoustic guitars, three different body shapes, three of the same cable. Okay. Then we have two microphone cables. Okay. Same cable. All the D'Addario. We have straps. We even did the straps. Three identical series straps. These are Joe Satriani straps. So we have number one, Joe Satch Scary Faces. We have number two, Joe Satch Skulls. I like that one. And number three, we have Joe Satch Snakes. Okay. So three cables, three straps. Then we have, you probably guessed, an ABC. So I could have three guitars plugged in. By the way, something worth noting here. If you ever buy something like this, Morley has an ABC pedal, which is different than an ABY. One of their models, you see this over here. This is important. Pay attention. You see over here, this says in or out. There's another model that they have that just say in. Why is that important? That means one guitar in, three amplifiers output. In this case, because it's in or out, I could do three guitars in, one amplifier output. So I could do three guitars, one amp, or one guitar, three amps, all signified by that little in or out. There, again, there's another version that only says in. If you see just in, that means one guitar, three out. That's it. Okay. So we're going to use that to plug all three guitars in when I do the plug-in. Okay. Made in the USA. Very nice. Then, now this should be a three pack, I think. Is this a, oh, it is a three pack. Okay. So they're all going to be strung with this. These here are phosphor bronze, acoustic 10 to 47. So these are like extra light because I'm a baby and I like my acoustic guitar strings light. So I'm probably going to do three acoustic guitars. So I only needed one of these, but I figured if a string breaks, I got another set. Science, my friend, science. What we're doing here is science. So have that. And I'm going to do a video when I'm setting it all up. We'll do a video. A nice humipack. Humidipack. I had to sound that one out. And then, if you want the complete care, this here is the other, which has restore detailer, guitar wax, fingerboard conditioner, a cradle to do setups, more polishing cloths. You can never have too many of those. More string cleaner, more spray. So there are other non-branded, D'Addario, of course, but they're standard cleaning kit. So that is everything to prepare the instruments for this science experiment. Then, there we go. Last but not least, I have this here. So again, three different guitars. I'm going to play them unplugged. You'll get to listen 40 feet away of, oh, that. The jumbo does sound bigger, you know, that type of thing. But then I am going to plug them in to see what do they sound like acoustically, especially in that open setting. So this is what I'm going to use for that. Okay, so let me try to get this properly in camera here, in frame. That should work. Okay, so this one here is their loud box. And the loud box, I'll just show you what it has over here. I'll read it to you. So we have Bluetooth, okay, 180 watt bi-amplified, two input channels for instrument or microphone, 24 volt phantom power for condenser mics, master volume, three band EQ, dual effects for each channel, reverb and delay, chorus flange, slap echo with depth control, reverb and delay effect level, chorus flange, or slap echo on or off, individual effect loops, feedback fighting, quarter inch, eighth inch stereo aux inputs, balanced XLR DI output, channel mute, headphone output, dual foot switch input, and 30 pounds. So that's all the spec on here. And let me pop it out of the box. Actually, I'm going to put it on the floor now because to deadlift this at this height might be a little difficult. So, power cord. What we have here is an amp, which I'll show you the back real quick. It has this little kickstand, so you could lean it all the way back if you want. It goes right under there. It has a foot switch, aux, DI out, channel one, channel two, with their own effects loops, which is really nice. Power. And then on the front, let me do this real quick. And this is their flagship acoustic amp. Let me see something real quick if I could. You can't really see. I'm trying to get the see through the Tolex, which is tough. Okay, let me tip that forward for you. And that's what we have up front. So input one, input two, controls are all the same. Gain, low, mid, high, anti-feedback, phase, effect level, effect A, effect B, time, aux, volume, depth, headphones, channel mute, tweeter, pairing, phantom. And that's it. This is their flagship acoustic guitar amplifier. That, my friends, is the unboxing. Oh, use the flashlight to see through the screen. Should we do that? We could do that. Need a Strauss to the rescue. There should be a battery in here. Here is my flashlight. By the way, nice kit. Now the question is the, how do I turn this on? There's no batteries in here. Hold on. Are the batteries in here? Bear with me. There's a 9-volt battery. I don't see batteries in here for this. I have a 9-volt battery, but I don't see batteries in here for the little flashlight. Yeah, unless it's in here somewhere. Maybe not. So maybe I'm surprised that the little one doesn't have the hold on. Yeah, there's no batteries in that, so I probably have to buy the batteries for it. Okay, anyway. That, my friends, is the unboxing. Guitar Man says, have a Line 6 1500 that you use for acoustic. Doesn't the front grill come off? I don't think the front grill does come off. I don't see any tabs. You know, I could kind of see it Actually, I could use my cell phone. Hold on.
It's hard to tell. It's very hard to tell.
But I'm sure the spec is on the website. You'd rip it off. Should I just like cut the grill? Oh, actually, you could kind of see it with the lighting here. Yeah, you could see there's one speaker here. It's funny, I could see it better in the video than in person. Hang on. Now, see, this one over here is pretty obvious. Let me back up. Maybe I'm just too close. There's one speaker here. I'm guessing there's one here. There's one here. There's probably a port and a tweeter is my guess. Very hard to see. And I don't think the grill comes off. I could see. Hang on. I'll tell you right now. It doesn't look like the grill is meant to come off. Oh, hold on. I think the grill might come off. Maybe not. Maybe not. And I don't want to rip it, you know. No, I don't think the grill comes off. So I think, we're an hour in. I will show you one more thing that I picked up. This here. This was a, I got this for a crazy good deal. This here is the Hellcat. Not the Springfield Armory Hellcat. This is the Fender Hellcat. You can see there's little Hellcats on there, a couple of skull inlays. And this is a concert series acoustic, nice inlays, gold, bit guard, and Tim Armstrong. It's a Tim Armstrong signature series, Little Dead or Alive. Okay. Dead or Alive. James Norton, dude, thank you so much. Great room. Happy 4th of July. You got to plug in that Randall for me. Which Randall are you? I can't do it today because I just have all this stuff behind me. Maybe on the next show, I'll get the Randall going for you next weekend. But James, dude, the super chat, super kind of you. Thank you so much. Got to let me know which Randall, though. I got a few of them. Oh, fluttering. Crap. Hold on. Sorry. Let me fix my audio. I had echo cancellation. Let's do that again. The dimension of the neck is might be a little thicker than normal, but it's I don't know, to me it's very comfortable. I'm not stretching. It's just, you know, very comfortable. I could do a circle. My hands aren't that big either, you know. Should I not play that song? There it is. Thank you. Thank you for all of the nice feedback. About this one. Let's play Name That Tune. My fellow rockers, thank you so much for being here tonight. Thank you for the super chat. Super generous of you all. I appreciate it. So, thank you. One of those bad boys right there. I had a lot of fun tonight. Rico B from Aloha from Hawaii. Well, forget about it, from New Jersey. Peter Urban says, I'm going to hang this up one second. Let me just do this and then we'll do a nice proper wrap. So, again, this is the Tim Armstrong. Not a lot of money, and it's a nice guitar. Nice guitar for not a lot of dough. I love the black and the gold. I love the Hellcats. I love the skulls. I'll give you a nice close-up on the skulls and the Hellcats. So those are the skulls, and the Hellcats are this way. And again, this is a Tim Armstrong signature. I like the tuners on the back, the tuning pegs. It's kind of the open old country western style, which I like. Binding on the front and the back. Concert size. So it's kind of sort of like a jumbo without feeling too oversized. Binding on the neck, the front of the body, back of the body, and the sound hole. I think rosewood. Again, a nice gold. Just a nice guitar. And it's actually made in, I think, Indonesia. I think this is made in Indonesia. Indonesia, yeah, made in Indonesia. And it just, it's nice. Okay, let me hang this up. So, my fellow rockers, I want to thank everyone for being here tonight. Again, the super chats were very generous. Aljon, actually, Aljon, maybe we could get like an epi acoustic in this little thing that I'm doing. Let's maybe you and I talk about that offline. It's been a while, dude. We got to catch up anyway. But yeah, maybe there's something there. So Guitar Man says, thanks, Tone King. Always fun seeing you. Thank you so much. For the Patreon peeps, do me a favor. Just send me an email, info@thetoneking.com. And we will sort all of this out. So, Guitar Man, thank you so much, dude. Great Vanzini, thank you for being here. Desert says, anytime you want to store some of that gear at my house, let me know. Will do. Benjamin Payne says, I'm going to be learning to make macrame this week. I don't know what that is. Brian Spaulding, Gary Davlin, dude, thank you. Great Vanzini. Yeah, happy 4th of July, everyone. Again, if you're in America, you're celebrating the 4th, be safe. Fireworks are dangerous, but be safe, have fun, get your hot dogs and hamburgers on. I just hope everyone has a great, great night, great evening, great week, great July 4th, so on and so forth. Again, super generous with the super chats. Thank you. I appreciate it. My fellow rockers, be good, have fun, and as always, rock on. See you later.